and welcome to Cocktail Cinema. Welcome back. My name is Isaac. This is the show where I discuss a recent film that I've seen, as well as tell you how to make a wonderful cocktail. Today we're making the French 75 and also discussing the film Blade Runner 2049. Check it out.
I thought you might be able to help me with the case. Any idea where I could find him?
You police plan on taking me in?
Replicants are the future, but I can only make so many. I had the lock, and he has the key.
I think I found him.
That's not possible. If this gets out, we've bought ourselves a war.
French 75 is made with 1.5 ounce gin, 3/4 ounce lemon juice, 1/2 ounce simple syrup, topped off with dry champagne, and then garnished with a lemon twist. What you want to do is add all of your elements into your mixer over ice. Go ahead and shake vigorously, then strain into your glass. Top off with your dry champagne, drop in your lemon twist, and there you have the French 75. Cheers. Merci. The film we're talking about today is Blade Runner 2049, starring Ryan Gosling, Harrison Ford, directed by Denis Villeneuve, and photographed by Roger Deakins. Before I discuss the film that I've just seen, just a little bit of background into my history as it comes to the film Blade Runner, I prefer the final cut. I always sort of wrestled with the theatrical cut that comes with the voiceover narration done by Harrison Ford. And as legend tells it, Harrison Ford was not a big fan of the idea of the voiceover, so he purposefully tanked it. I don't know if that story is true or not, but I've heard it and it sounds true based on what you've got in the actual film. So he didn't like the idea of it, so he purposefully did a bad read, hoping that the studio wouldn't use it, and they used it anyway. That's part of my sort of history with the film. I always had a bit of a hard time watching it because I felt like there were a lot of things sort of being spoon-fed. I would have preferred to figure out on my own, which is what you have in the final cut of the film. Drops the narration out completely and really just lets you uncover the mystery with our detective, Decker. So now come to Blade Runner 2049. I'm not gonna really talk too much actually about the plot of the film because I feel like it's best to walk in cold to this film. We've got Agent K, which is played by Ryan Gosling, and in the tracking down of a replicant is asked a question or is told that he's able to do his job, but he's only able to do his job because he's never seen a miracle, which is the beginning of the character, I believe, beginning to question his purpose. That's about all I want to really say about the film because I really don't want to ruin it for you if you haven't seen it. One of the main themes in this film is the existential identity crisis. Asking important questions like, what does it mean to be alive? What does it mean to be born? What does it mean to have a soul? What does it mean to have memories, and how much those memories shape or inform our past as well as our future? And ultimately, the question of what does it mean to really be human? There's something from the original film that is said throughout it that says that the replicants are more human than human. So what I believe this film does is takes the themes and concerns of the original film and expands them, lending its own perspective, and evolves them in meaningful ways. Ryan Gosling's performance is very good in this film. What he does really well is really lets the camera sort of capture his thoughts and emotions without indicating, lets the audience follow along the mystery along with him without sort of trying to spoon feed where you should be while you're watching. The cinematographer of this film is Roger Deakins. Big fan of his work. He's been nominated for 14 different Academy Awards, if I'm not mistaken, and I would not be surprised at all to see another nomination for this film, let alone a well-deserved win for his contribution to American cinema as a whole. So what he does is really help you return to the visual world of Blade Runner, but also returning that sense of awe, returning that sense of marvel, stunning, bleak future of gray vistas, industrial wreckage, sort of an eco-collapsed world. There are also some really just beautiful coloring to this. It almost has a consistency of candy with these artificial lights. And another great thing, take a sip of that. Also great use of lighting. It creates these impressionistic shadows and angular lines that really, really make this film come alive. This film, I feel, was really done right. It moves at a constant and confident pace that allows the audience to uncover the mystery along with our protagonist. I feel like it was made by a director who really appreciated the original film and really wanted to pay homage to that film, but also at the same time give you his own perspective on the characters, where they're at, and also the very nature of the characters themselves, without drawing a conclusion for you, but allowing you to draw that conclusion on your own. Harrison Ford also gives a really great performance, return as Decker, with, to me, more emotion than in the original. Harrison Ford is one of my favorite actors. I love his performance in the original Blade Runner, so it's really great to see him on screen again. So for this film filled with art, life, feeling, amazing direction, great acting, I'm going to have to recommend that for Blade Runner 2049 that you order yourself a double. Cheers. Well, thanks so much for joining me here again on Cocktail Cinema. I'm sorry that I was gone. If you missed me, did you not miss me? Do you not know who I am talking to you at all? Is this your first time watching these? Well, hopefully I'll be making a lot more and a lot more regularly because I like alcohol and I like talking about film. Thanks so much for joining me and I will see you at the next review. Bye.
You're a cop. I had your job once.
Things were simpler then.
What do you want?
I want to ask you some questions.
We were being hunted.
By who?
You do not know what pain is yet. You will learn.
We have to go.
Where is he?